Hello friends, I am Pushpa Kumawat, Assistant Professor, Biani Girls B.Ed. College. I welcome you all on behalf of GuruKPO.com. Today I am going to present a lecture about sentence. When we speak, when we communicate to each other, we use different kinds of words and different kinds of group of words. These group of words known as sentence. So, the sentence is a group of words which is having a complete sense, and a sentence is having two parts. The first one is subject and the second one is predicate. So friends, what is subject and what is predicate? We will know it. Subject is a part of a sentence about which something is told, and predicate is that part of a sentence that gives some information about the subject. For example, he runs. In this sentence, he is working as a subject and runs is working as a predicate, because he is the subject, he is the door about which something is told in the sentence. Whether runs is a predicate because it gives information that Ram is running. So what is done by Ram? So Ram is running. Friends, previously we have known about the subject and predicate, that what is subject and what is predicate. Now we will know the different parts of a subject. A subject is mainly divided into two parts, qualifier and head word. Qualifier is the main part of a subject that qualifies about a subject, and head word is itself a subject. For example, a boy plays. In this sentence, a is denoting qualifier, boy is denoting head word, and place is denoting a predicate. Some more examples of this series are: the girls are going, the sun sets, some boys play, etc. Previously we have known about the different parts of the sentence, which are subject and predicate. Now in this series we will know the different parts of a subject. A subject is mainly divided into two parts, which are qualifier and head word. What is qualifier? Qualifier is a part of sentence which qualifies a subject in a sentence. Head word is itself the subject. We will understand it by an example. A boy plays. In this sentence, A is qualifier. Boy is the head word, which is the subject of this sentence, and all these things are told about the boy, which is the subject. Plays is a predicate because plays is the action which is done by the subject. These are the parts of a subject. Now we will know the different parts of the qualifier, that how many kinds of qualifiers are there in a sentence. Now we have the division of the qualifier. The first is determiner and the second one is adjective. A qualifier is basically divided into two parts or two types. These are the determiner and adjective. Determiner is that which determines a subject, and adjective is that which shows the qualities of head word as well as noun and pronoun. Now we will understand these by some examples. A beautiful bird is singing. The clever fox ran away. Some good boys do not disturb. In these sentences, a, the and some are denoting determiner. Beautiful, clever and good are the adjectives which shows the qualities or the additional information about the subject, that is the head word of a sentence. Bird, fox, boys are working as head word. Is singing, ran away, do not disturb. All these are the predicate, which is the essential part of a sentence. Now we will know the another type of a subject, which is gerund. Gerund is a form of subject or form of verb which can be used as a noun in a sentence or as a subject in a sentence. So gerund are the words which is having ing in itself. For example, verb plus ing. So it is working as a noun. Verb which works a noun like a noun and also known as verbal noun when it is adding by ing. For example, walk plus ing will make walking. So the examples are as given here. Walking is good for health. Smoking is harmful. Swimming is an exercise. In all these sentences, walking, smoking and swimming, which are the verb and working here as a subject, as a noun, when it is used by adding ing. So these are the types of gerund which can be used in a sentence as a subject. So this is another type or another part of subject like gerund. Now we will know the another one more type of subject, that is infinitive. Now we will know what is infinitive. Infinitive is a verb which can be used as a subject or as a noun in a sentence when it is used with the first form of the verb plus to. So when we add to before the first form of the verb, it works as a noun in a sentence or as a subject in a sentence. So we can see it by some examples. To work is our duty. To forgive is divine. To obey our parents is our duty. In these sentences, to work, to forgive, to obey is working here as a noun or as a subject. So this is the form of verb which can be used as a noun or as a subject by adding to before a first form of the verb. So friends, we have known all the parts of a sentence which are very important and very necessary in our communication, in our talking. So friends, if you like this video, so please comment and share. And for more information, log in to our website www.gurukpo.com. Thank you and thank you.